Hey guys, Brennan here with Brennan's Tech Byte. You all asked for a demo of iOS 7 on the iPad, so right now I'm going to show you how it looks on this iPad. This is the iPad 3rd generation, so it does run a little bit slow. So as with the iPhone, if you swipe up, you have quick access to Control Center. Here's your volume and music playback controls on the left side. And then on the right side, you have quick access to your clock and camera. Below that is an adjustment for your screen's brightness. And then in the center, you have controls for airplane mode, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, do not disturb, and also I can lock the screen orientation of my iPad. Now if I slide down from the top, I can launch Notification Center, and it works just like it does on the iPhone. You can see today's notifications, all your notifications, and missed notifications. And then one new thing they added with iOS 7 for the iPad is now there's a little camera icon on the bottom right hand corner. And then if you swipe up, it will launch your camera. I'll talk about the camera later, but first let's get into the meat and potatoes of iOS 7 on the iPad. Before we get to all of the apps, I want to show you a couple things. If you double tap the home button, it will reveal the new multitasking view. Here you can see all of the apps that you have open, and then you can slide left or right to view all those apps. If you want to close an app, just swipe up on it and it will disappear. If you want to close multiple apps, just take two or three fingers and then slide up. Just like on the lock screen, if you slide up on the home screen, it will reveal Control Center. And then if you swipe down on the iPad, you will see your notifications. So right now, I'm going to give you a quick overview of all of the apps on the iPad. First, let's start with the clock. We have a stopwatch, a timer, an alarm, and also a world clock. If you tap on one of the clocks, you can enlarge it, and then you can pinch back in to close it. Next, let's move to calendar. You have different views. You have a day view, a week view, a month view, and a year view. Contacts. It pretty much looks the same as the previous version. You have all your contacts on the left-hand side, and then on the right side, it displays that contact. Next, let's take a look at Notes. It has the same layout, but a different interface. Now let's move on to Messages. We see the same thing here. It has the same layout, just a different interface. The next application is Apple Maps. If you touch the Share button right here, you can share your map on all these places right here. And you can also add this map and location as a bookmark, and it will save it to your iPad. And then if you hit the info button on the bottom right hand corner, you can do more with your maps. You can drop a pin or you can change the view of your map. Next, let's move to reminders. On the left side, you can see all of your list and you can also see how it's translucent. It's kind of cool. And then on the right side, you have all your specific reminders. Photo booth. This app really hasn't changed, just the icon. It still has all the same effects. And also the interface for FaceTime is still practically the same. Now let's move to the camera app, which has been completely redesigned. Now Apple created three cameras into one app. If you swipe up, you can launch your video camera. Swipe down one time to go back to the photo camera. And then swipe down again to go to the square camera. And a new thing with the photo camera is now you can take HDR photos. Next, we have the iTunes Music Store, where we can purchase music, TV shows, and movies, and this app has been slightly redesigned. And of course, they have their App Store, where you can purchase all your apps. One new feature of the App Store is called Near Me. If you tap on it, it will show you useful apps for your location. Newsstand still works the same exact way, except we get this translucent bookshelf, which looks pretty cool. Next is Game Center. This app has been completely redesigned and there is no more green felt or poker table. You also have these cool animations when you tap on these bubbles. Now let's move to Safari. You can go back and forth in between pages by swiping left or right on the screen. On the top right here, you have your back and forward buttons. You have the share button where you can share the website. On the top right hand corner, we have our bookmarks and our reading lists. The next button displays our iCloud tabs. If you hit the plus button, it opens up a new tab and it also shows you all your bookmarks. The next app is Mail. It essentially still has the same exact layout. It's very similar to the old version of Mail. Next, let's move to the new music app. The new feature in this app is iTunes Radio. It works just like Pandora. So if you select a specific song, artist, or album, it will play similar songs. And then as with the old music app, on the bottom you have access to all your playlists, artists, songs, albums, and genres. Next is videos, where you can see all your movies, TV shows, music videos, and home videos. We have photos. On the bottom you have a photo, shared, and albums view. I have my camera roll and my photo stream album. A lot of you have asked about this wallpaper. I guess you guys must really like it. So I'll leave a link in the description below so you guys can download it. As Apple showed in their keynote address, you can now sort your photos by moments, collections, and years. And the final app is Settings. So there's your quick look of iOS 7 on Apple's iPad. You can check out some more of my iOS 7 videos by clicking on the screen. Or if you are using a mobile device, you can click on the links in the description below. Don't forget to check out that wallpaper, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.